Welcome to PC Mac. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can configure the external storage on NextCloud using FTP. So here we are using NextCloud on Docker with the help of DietPi, and in this setup I'll show you how you can configure your external storage through FTP. So before starting this video, I would like you to please go ahead and subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. So let's do it. First of all, let's go ahead and open our NextCloud. It's right here, and then we need to go into the external storage from here on the top right corner, then go to settings. After we open the settings, then we need to go from here to external storage. In the last video, we already configured it on the Samba server, so it will be similar if you are going to do it on an open media vault or either on DietPi. So the method will be same. Now we will go ahead and do that with the FTP. So let's name it as FTP, and from here just select FTP. Now it will ask for your settings like host name, remote subfolder, secure FTPS, and then username and password. So first of all, let's check it. It's an optional thing, but let's go ahead and check it. Now we require the FTP settings of our server. So I have a website and I have an online FTP account, so we are going to configure that here. But you can also configure your local FTP account that is on the Open Media Vault, so you can use that as well. So for the settings, what I need to do is, let me just take you to the settings, and the settings are right here. Let's fill the settings first of all. The host name is this, and the user ID is this, and then I'll put the password, and now we'll put the remote folder name, and the remote folder name is public underscore HTML. So let's put this here. So these are all the settings. You can find this settings on your website. If you host any website over the internet, you can easily find these settings under the FTP settings. So let's go ahead and click on the right icon, and then it will check the online configuration, and you can see a green check right here. Let's go ahead and click here on external storage on the top as well under the personal settings, and let's check the settings are correct or not. Click here one more time to recheck, and it's give us a green tick, and that means it's connected. Let's just go ahead and open our main page and see whether we have the folder for FTP or not. So we have the folder for FTP right here. Let's go ahead and click on it, and it will downloading the information from the website server. Will take a moment. We need to put the port number here. The default port number is 21. In my case, it's 21, and the default is also 21. So if you have a different port number, you just need to mention it here. Next to it, you need to put a colon and then 21. It might take some time to configure the FTP because it's an online FTP. So if it's on the local network, it will do it faster, but as it's on the online, it requires some authentications, so that's why it's taking that much of time. So we have the folder right here with the name FTP. It's synchronizing right now, so it might take some time. In between, let me just take you to my FTP account settings. As you can see, FTP accounts, and here you can see the host name, the IP address, the FTP port, and then the username and the password, and the folder that the file uploading are public underscore HTML. So this is the way you can easily configure your FTP onto your NextCloud, and you can easily move your data to the FTP, or you can download the data from the FTP folder. So guys, that's it for today. This is the way how you can configure FTP on NextCloud. If you have any questions, you can write them down in the comment section. I'll try to answer them. And please do subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.